We flew to Biak from Jakarta to Sulawesi, where we boarded our liveaboard ship, which would become home for the next 10 days, an MSY Seahorse. It is a Phoenician-rigged Sulawesi schooner. Whale sharks have a mouth that can be 1.5 meters wide, containing 300 to 350 rows of tiny teeth and 10 filter pads which it uses to filter feed. It was not until 1828 when the first whale shark specimen known to science was discovered off the South African coast. Dr. Andrew Smith formally described the species later that year as the largest living shark in the ocean. Divers are normally told not to approach the whale sharks and keep your distance so as not to scare them. Here in Cenderawasih, you have to swim to try and avoid the sharks from bumping into you. It is the sole member of the genus Rhynchodon. The species originated about 60 million years ago. The largest confirmed individual had a length of 12.65 meters and a weight of more than 21 metric tons. Whale sharks are quite curious animals and will swim up to you, tilt their head towards you, and then have a good look at you. Whale sharks seem to like the bubbles coming from the scuba divers and like to swim through the bubbles, almost like mantas do. Maybe the bubbles do tickle their skins. They love the bubbles. The whale sharks of Cenderawasih Bay swim into the bubbles on purpose. They appear to like the feeling. They will even try to gulp the bubbles with their mouths. Whale sharks are quite inquisitive. When they are swimming in your direction and you notice them tilting their bodies to your side to get a better look at you with the one eye, then you can be sure that they will swim directly towards you. We found that when there were a couple of scuba divers in the water, the whale shark would approach and swim past each and every one of us in turn. All you have to do is to stay in one place and they will find you. The whale sharks also don't seem to mind the flashlights from cameras or video strobes at all. It's really so impressive to watch these gentle giants just slowly gliding past you. Some of the remoras following the whales around were themselves quite big. Whale sharks are ovoviviparous, which means that the young hatch from eggs retained within the mother, so that she can then give birth to live young. Whale shark pups are about 2 feet long when they are born. They only reach sexual maturity when they reach a length of about 9 meters. This means that the whale sharks can only start reproducing at a maturity age of about 30 years. So their very existence is in danger, even though it's thought that whale sharks may live as long as between 100 and 150 years. The whale shark is a filter feeder, one of only 3 known filter feeding shark species. The other two are the basking shark and the megamouth shark. It feeds on macroalgae, plankton, krill, and small fish. Most of the time the whale sharks swim just below the surface, but at times they can go quite deep and you really need to watch your depth gauge, because when you're taking photographs you're not always aware of what your depth is and you might get a bad surprise. In Cenderawasih, the whale sharks don't just pass by seasonally, like in most other places where dive operators will drop you on snorkel in the path of a single shark so that you can get a glimpse of it for 5 minutes. That is if you have a long breath and can swim very fast. The Cenderawasih whale sharks stay year-round. They circle under the fishermen platforms called bagans, sucking some fish out of their storage nets. The name whale shark comes from the fish's size, being as large as some species of whales and also a filter feeder like the baleen whales. Whale sharks have five large pairs of gills. The head is wide and flat with two small eyes at the front. Whale sharks are grey with a white belly. Their skin is marked with pale yellow spots and stripes which are unique to each individual, almost like the Australian Aboriginal dot paintings. The whale shark has three prominent ridges along its sides. The skin can be up to 10 centimeters thick. The shark has a pair of dorsal and pectoral fins. Juvenile tails have a longer upper fin than a lower fin, while the adult tail becomes semilunate. After a good day's diving, you get the most perfect sunsets over the Bay of Cenderawasih.